Good morning, friends. Welcome to GoOnlineTrainings.com. So we are loading the data from OLTP system to data warehousing systems, and part one, part two is got over. In the part one, what we had done was we had loaded all the data from OLTP to stage. This is what is the phase one. Then later in the part two session, we had taken all the stage data and we're able to load into data warehouse. Here we had created dimensional fact tables, and we're also created with dim timetable, dim location table, extra. The how to create those tables also have explained. And later we had loaded the data from, you know, this to this, and these are the tables from OLTP and staging. Then part two, from the stage to data warehouse, and we had loaded the data, and these are the tables in the data warehouse: dim product and dim customer, dim location and dim time. And only the left table is that fact sales table. Today I'm going to load the data into fact sales table. Okay, and let us understand how to load the data into fact sales table. And if you wanted to see the how to load the data in the staging and data warehouse, you have to see previous two videos. Okay, so now what are the deliverables from this case study? I also have explained in the previous video: SQL scripts and for the stage data warehouse, and packages for the stage data warehouse, and ETL mapping document. This will be always with this, you know, ETL work, and we have to create a deployment guide to install those in various environments, right? So we have dev environment, same kind of a things will be available, and the testing environment in this also same thing, same kind of a, you know, OLTP stage data warehouse, everything will be available. And the production where you have original, you know, data would be available of amazon.com. we're talking about amazon.com, right? So let us quickly start, you know, loading the fact sales data. So let me take this and take a new package. Now go here, take new SSS package now here, and rename as so F2 is for the rename. Just come here, press F2 and F2 and Control C. I'm doing it, and let me just rename. This is load to data warehouse and fact sales table. So this is how you have to do it. Now go to data flow task and drag and drop, create one data flow task here, and go to previous package, any one of the package, and let me copy this. These are, you know, connections. You can easily copy to the new things, because since, you know, creating from control, you can, instead of creating from the scratch, you better copy from the earlier packages. That will be the best thing to do. So copy this and go to my new package and come here, and you have to paste these connections, because when you paste it, you will not do any kind of a mistakes here. The, you know, server names and the database names, everything will be here, so you will not be able to do any mistakes here. This is the better thing, better approach to do that. And let me go here, and I wanted to read the data from the fact sales table, and I have to take OLEDB sales source and double click on this and quickly configure this to my OLT, you know, to my staging area, because I wanted to move the data from staging area. And I have all these tables are here only. I have a product, this is OLTP database. I have staging, this is my staging database, and I have a data warehouse. This is also here. So when you go here, I have category master, customer master, product master, and everything is there. This is the, you know, product database. So when you go to the staging, and you have same tables. So let me go here and expand we have category master, but we have prefixed with stage category master. Somebody will say category master underscore stage, customer master underscore stage, like that. So the four tables are available. So I have some data in the packed sales table also. Already we have got loaded data. So it is in the fact, but when you go to the staging area, now the data is available here. So how many rows we have? 27 rows we have. When you go to OLTP, and let me read the data, how many rows we have? We have approximately 20. No, we have not approximately, exactly 27 rows. Now the OLTP and the staging is having same kind of a data. So now what I'm going to do, let me go here, double click on this. So go to data where, stage, and take the stage sales table and go to columns. These are the columns I'm planning to take, and click on OK. Now, so directly always what you do, you directly take the ODBC, and let us understand first OLEDB connection, and click, double click on this, and data warehouse and fact sales table I have to use here, and click on mappings. Now this is where you would understand product ID equals to, product key, that is fine. Customer ID equals to customer key, that is also fine. And sale date and sale date key. So when you drag and drop something, so what is going to happen? The sale date is definitely it is a date. And this is an integer, key means integer, right? So definitely it is not going to go the data. When you run the package, it's going to fail. Okay. The quantity sold can go, the sales amount can go, and we have a delivery date key is also not there. We have sale date key is not there. Well, sale date is there, sale date key is not there. So delivery date. So 1, 2. And a location key, we don't have any location also here. So this is also a big problem. So these are the things we have to worry about. Sale date key, because it is integer, and this is date time. So what you have to do, you have to take this table, and the sale date key is always a date key, right? So when you go here, okay, and this is my table. So when I'm taking this data from OLTP or to the staging, so this is my staging, right? So when you go here, this is a date time column. But when I go to data warehouse, so I have created this table. When you see the structure of the table, this is the structure of my fact sales table. You can understand what is this product key, which is a primary key to this, foreign key to this, sorry. And the customer key, this is a foreign key to this. And the sale date key, it is an integer. Remember this. So it is not a date time. But sale date, so normally when you see sale date here is, date time. So what we have to do, so we have to pick up the, we have to match a dim time table. So we had a dim time table here, right? So using this dim time table, you have to map these dates with these dates. If that this date and this date is mapping, for example, we have let me go here. So the product ID, customer ID, this is what is the date, July 3rd, right? So we have to go, July 3rd means this is the date. This date we have to pick up, and that date we have to insert as part of, sale date key, because it is an integer. And to do that, we have to use lookup, okay? Lookup to dim timetable and get the data. And quantity sold and this, no issues. And the delivery date also we don't have, because delivery date key integer. And the delivery date is also having some kind of a dates. And again, you have to use one more lookup. And now delivery is 7th and July 10th, 2012. And you have to look up dim timetable. And July 10th means this is the date we have to, put it as part of this case. So this is the integer. So because when you take dim time, the date key is, you know, I have declared as an integer. So date key is completely integer, you can see. So there is no problem if so date key is an integer. And the same thing is possible here. We have, you know, sale date key is integer and delivery date key is integer. So dim time, one lookup we have to use here. And again, dim time, one more lookup we have to use to get this key. Okay. And later, you have to also, you know, get the location key. Location key is not available in the stage. So when you go here, there is no location available here. Okay. But where is location available? Location available not in this table. Okay. So we have stationary and this categories. And let me show me this table. And inside this, we don't have any location. So one pen, the cost and the category ID. So we have the location is available only in this table. So you have to take this data. So whenever this guy is, you know, interacting with this, so I have to pick this, you know, the customer ID and his city, I have to compare with dim location city. Okay. So I have to have dim location. So wherever the Bangalore equals to Bangalore. So for example, I have Bangalore here and this and that I have to compare and get 105 and that 105 I have to insert here. So this is also one more lookup I have to do. Clear? So now quickly go there and these are the issues. Sale date key and we have to worry about delivery date key and we have to worry about this one. So these are the pending things. Okay, let me remove this now. Let me remove the connection. Now, so first let me take a dim time table. So for that, I'm going to use a lookup. So go here and so what I'm doing, look up full date. Full date we have to look up and get sale date key. Okay. So now double click on this and always we have to say redirect rows to no match output, but I am not putting any no match output as of now. So full cache mode connections, go to, you know, data warehouse because I have to choose dim timetable. So dim timetable is this. If you wanted to pick up all the columns, you better pick up. Otherwise, you can, because you have to compare this and this, right? So remaining columns are not at all needed. Then you can write a query here. So date key and everything, because I don't want to compare, I don't want to take entire table because I need this column and this column. You better take only those two columns. So that is a better thing. Or you can also, so copy with headers, you can say. And when you say headers, you will be able to get the column names and with the data also. I don't need the data. So date key and full date only I need because I have to compare with full date and get the date key. This would be the better approach. So take only these two columns and copy and go here. You should be able to paste. That is also fine. Okay. Preview because I'm doing only with this, right? So better take this and go to columns. And here we have to map. So the sale date I have to map and the full date I have to map. Okay. So this is a date, you know, this is a date column. So sale date, full date and get date key. And this date key will be sale date. You can rename this sale date key. Okay. So because it is output alias, alias means you can have a different name there. So sale date key, so done. And what about this? Can I do like this again? Can I compare like this and get one more like this? So you cannot have. So always you can have only one. So better you take a sale date key and you can compare sale date key and this and you get the sale date key here and click on OK. So here look up full date and get the sale date key. And we have to perform one more thing here. So whatever the date, the matched data you're getting, get. And here, this time, what we are doing it. And look up full date and get delivery date key. delivery date ke you have to use double click on this and no match output, go to connection, and here let me use the same copy paste. And oh sorry, so here I have to take the same query and copy paste control C and quickly go here control V and preview the data. I'm getting the data, go to columns. This time what you have to do, you are able to get sale date, and now after the lookup you got a sale date key also here. Now you have to take delivery date and get the date key, and the date key you can rename. This is a delivery date key. Okay, so delivery date key. So now you're able to get those two things also. But afterwards, you have to do so. This is over. So what we had done with this? So we had done, when you go to the customer, the product key, customer key, sale date key, and delivery date key is done. And the location is, because this is the one you will be having in the ETL document. Look up dim time table based on full date and, you know, get date key and insert into this. So this will be your sale date key. And here also, look up dim time table based on full date, get. So blah, blah, blah. So location key, what is this? Look up dim location table. So let me, but this location key, I don't have any appropriate column in the source sales table also. This is extra column. For this, what they are doing, so look up dimension table. So let us first look up dimension table. So let me take one more lookup and let me put this and matching. Okay, lookup match, and here what I'm going to do, I'm going to write lookup what is that, city, lookup city, and get the location key and get location key. So this is what is the thing you have to do it. Okay, so now double click on this, and again no match rows. I'm not, you know, keeping anything in the no match. So dim location is available, so here only. So take dim location table, you can preview this, and this city you have to look up and click close, and you know, or columns. Now tell me, when you go here, where is the city column here? Because I wanted to look up. So product ID, customer ID, sale date, quantity sold, sales amount, delivery date, sale date key, delivery date key. So where is that? So nowhere location key is available, nowhere country is available, nowhere state is available, nowhere city is also available here. So, but how do you match that? So you are again stuck. So you cannot do anything here, because if I wanted to join the city is available in one more table. The table is known as a, you know, city is available in which table? So the city is available when you go to the stage table, and the city is available in this table. So remember this, and you have to include this also. Otherwise you will not be able to get, because you have to get the city from here and compare. So the better you have to go here before, you know, this is, you know, dim location we are putting it. So before that, let me include one more lookup. So I have to include one more table here. The one more table is known as, so match data I have to send. So here I have to, you know, get the data from, you know, stage customer master. Okay, so let me go here and double click on this, and here you know, redirect rows to no match output, go to connection. I have to connect to the stage table. Now in the stage table I have this. So where is the stage table? Stage customer master. Okay, or if you're filling this data in the destination table data warehouse also you can use. So I have used staging here. Let me go to the data warehouse. If you have the same data in the data warehouse already and there is no issue, okay, city. But let me go to data warehouse and let me go to customer table, and here we do not have city. Have you seen this? So when you don't have the city, definitely you cannot use this as a reference table. So whatever be the reason that the architect has designed like this, the city is not at all required here. Instead of the Praveen city, the city will be added here. So they had removed the city column from here. Otherwise, you can also take this table as a reference table when you're loading the data here. So you can use like this. But I cannot use because that column itself is not there. I had to forcefully use and stage. Or if the stage is not having, then you have to use OLTP, whatever it is. So customer master and the preview, and you have to go to the columns. Okay. Now, what you have to use? You have to map customer and customer, you have to map. Okay. And you have to pick up the city. This is what you have to do it. So the source customer ID, for example, source customer ID is when you go to the sales table, the customer ID, let us say 13, so 5 are customer. So the 5 customer, what is the city, you have to get it. So this is what we are doing it. The customer ID 5th. So when you go to the customer ID 5 in the customer table, and customer 5 is Prakash and Chennai. So this you are going to get it here. So that is what we are doing it here. So city we got it. Okay. Then later you take this lookup and again take the matched output and double click on this and you go here. No matching output, full connection, and go here. Now you have to go to the data warehousing. Then you have to include dim location here. And now you go to columns and you have a city column here. Have you seen this? Okay. So now this city and this city, you have to map and you have to get the location key. Okay. Like that, if some data is missing in the source table, then you have to use a lookup and do some kind of a comparison and matching and get the other column data. So city and city you are matching. Don't again click on city because this city and this city will become two cities in the destination. So never click. So whatever you don't need, uncheck. Only for the comparison, you're using this and this. And click location key. Fine. Okay. So later, what we do? So fact tables, remember this point. Okay. So dim tables, dimension tables will have incremental loading. I told you yesterday also. Incremental loading and fact table will not have incremental loading. So this what I told you. Why it is not going to have also I'm going to explain. Okay. So fact tables will not have incremental loading. So dim tables will have incremental loading. So you may have we have included SCD, or you have any kind of a lookup, or you can have your own logic, whatever you wanted to have. You can have SCD lookup merge statement, or you can have, if you have anything else that you should be able to use and load all these tables. Okay. And fact tables will not have incremental loading. Why fact tables will not have incremental loading also, I'll tell you. And so no SCD here. Directly you take this data and give it to the connection here. Matching data would go and double click on this. Now when you go to the mapping, okay, now what table I have to choose? I have to choose a fact sales table. Go to mappings. Now product key is nothing but a PAD, and customer key is nothing but what? Customer ID. And sale date key, quantity sold, sales amount, delivery date key, okay, and location key. So these are the things still pending. Sale date, city, all of them are still there, but we don't want to take them. Okay, So lots of things are still there. City is there, location key, we're able to do it. But you know, sale date is available, but we are not storing any data. The mapping is very, very important here. So we had mapped product ID, product key, customer ID, customer key, sale date you have. When you put sale date here, and while loading the data, you will get issue. You have to take sale date key. And you have delivery date also there. So don't put delivery date, put delivery date key. And you know, here we have city. City you should not put, you have to put, you know, location key. Like that you have to change, and this is how the things would happen. And click on OK. Now format, go to format and auto layout diagram, and everything is properly aligned. So OLEDB source, and you are doing some kind of a look up on, you know, sale date key, look up on, you know, delivery date key, and you have included stage customer master, because city column is available in the stage customer master that you had to include. Then later you had to use location key for the lookup, and all the destination data you're dumping into here. No incremental loading for this. Okay, now why no incremental loading also, I'll tell you. Now save and start. I go here. So in the data warehouse, we should be able to implement all the data here. So all 27 rows, you know, when the starting of the demo, we were discussing about, we had 27 rows. Now let me check. All the 27 rows have been included. Now customer key is 1, customer 2, customer 1. So wherever you have 105 and 105, and so what is the 105? What is the 105? When you go to the 105 table, you will be able to know what is that. So dim location table, when you go, the 105 means they belong to Bangalore city. Like that, all the data is included. Now here the data is properly created. Now when you rerun the package, for example, tomorrow you go to the OLTP system and this data is available here, the sales would happen, right? So you may have one more insert. I have 27 inserts here. You may insert one more thing here. So when you insert the data, again, when you run the staging and when you run the data warehousing, how do you get the incremental loading? Because I wanted to get only that data, but how is that possible? So because I did not include any incremental loading, so what is the thing people are going to do? So let us understand. Once, you know, fact table, the sales data loaded to data warehouse, what they do is that, you know, once the sales data is loaded to data warehouse, then delete all the data from source OLTP. So what they have to perform, they have to perform truncate operation in the source truncate table. So and what is the table name there? So they're going to take all the sales data here. So they're going to truncate all the sales data in the source. Why? Because think about Amazon.com. Amazon.com site is having all the product data. So when you go to Amazon here, let me go to Amazon site. So when I go to Amazon India site, what is the data I'm going to have it here? Let us understand. Now, you will have, you know, lots of data. These are the product data and product sales you're going to have. And you can go to the categories, books category, whatever the categories we have created, all these different categories they have created in NISRIC. And this is a category, and they can also have subcategory like that. Okay, so we did not include all of them. This is a main category, then you can also have subcategory. Inside that you have all electronics. Now, whenever you see the Amazon.com site, they're having category, subcategory, product name, product price, and all of them they're going to, you know, show you. But what data they're not going to give? They're not going to give you the sale data. For example, what is the, you know, the last 6 month sales? So where is the sale data? Which customer see, you know, got, what is the date, which customer bought, you know, which gave, you know, which item? That is not there here. Okay, so what is going to happen here? And in the OLTP databases, we know that we have a few tables, right? So what are the tables OLTP has? OLTP has a product table or product master table, and this is a dimension table, and customer master table. So customer master table, you may have address and everything. You have a sales table. Now, the product master table is used in the OLTP to show the data in this site. The customer master table also will be there in the OLTP because they wanted to get the address and phone numbers. Or whenever you log in, so blah, 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 all the data is here. So these two tables are needed for the OLTP. And here the data is limited. So because once the customer is joined in this, and after later is not going to register again and again, again and again. So I have joined 5 years back in Amazon.in. So later what's going to happen? So I'm not going to register. So, but I'm going to purchase lots of, you know, things here. So whenever I purchase, what is going to happen? The data is loaded in this table. So data is loaded in this table. Now what is going to happen? The analysis means we are not going to do anything here. Analysis means here only, because in the sales table, you're going to have what is the sales amount, what is the delivery date, all of them are, you know, here only. So this data you have loaded to the data warehouse, and you're not going to, you know, store anything here. So what they do is, if I delete the data from here, if I delete the data from here, from the source table, what is the problem? There is no problem at all. So because anyhow, this, when you delete this only, then OLTP size will decrease. Remember, because end of the day, OLTP size is limited, right? So they may have some kind of a, you know, 500 GB or even 1 terabyte of data they have. Okay. So when you have here, you don't have that much of data. You may have some 1 GB data is there, or you may have some kind of, say, you may have some 200 GB, 400 GB, or you may have, say, some kind of a 0.5 GB data is there. So think like this. And remaining tables, say remaining data, sales data, it is only occupying remaining, say, some 300 GB or some 100 GB or whatever it is. So large amount of, you know, space is going to occupy. Our remaining tables also may occupy, or it may have, say, let us think about a 10 GB of data, 20 GB or 100 GB of data. So all the sales data when you store, it will increase like this. Now what is going to happen tomorrow? If you delete all the data from here, now automatically what is going to happen? Lot of space, because when you delete the data here, it is only very little data, and the, you will not get much space here. But when you delete this data, and automatically if this sales table, think about a 300 GB of sales table you have, and when you delete this data, what is going to happen? You will get much space here. So in the normally OLTP, what's going to happen? Dimensional table data, these are called master tables data, they never delete it, but the fact table data, or known as a, you know, transactional table data, once the data loaded to the data warehouse, purchase data is loaded, and once sales data is loaded to data warehouse, then delete all the rows, all the data from the source table, and all the data we have to delete here. So what is going to happen? You may have one more stored proc or one more package, or they may have some kind of a thing here. So they're going to perform truncate table, and I'm doing it here only. So they may have a one more package for the deleting, but before deleting this data, they have to ensure what is that number of rows they're having, and these things they have to ensure that everything is properly inserted, number of rows and everything. And they take a copy of this table as of now, and they take a backup of this table, then they truncate the data here. So let me truncate. Now what is going to happen? I've loaded, I have truncated the table. That's it. Okay. When I truncated the table, the again, what is going to happen? The new sales going to start. Okay, once it is loaded, the new sales going to start. Otherwise, what some people will do is that they will have some kind of a flag here. So flag, you know, processed data or unprocessed data. Whatever the data got processed, they'll make it as a P, and the new data make it as what? Some kind of a new or something else. And they take that data and do it. And the processed data, they may keep it for 6 months here. Okay, and after 6 months, today they have loaded and they have a flag, one more column here. So they'll say it is processed. And whenever the neuro inserts, and the neuro will be unprocessed. Okay, whenever you're loading the data, you have to write some kind of a take only unprocessed data and do it. And in the diagrams, you have to have, you know, read the data from say stage table and where the flag equals to unprocessed. So instead of writing this, what you do is that you write a command, select star from stage table and where the flag equals to unprocessed. Only that data will be taken from in there. So that is also fine. Or some people will use, you know, other techniques also, but whatever they wanted to use, the data is always deleted in the OLTP system. Because of that, OLTP size remains always low. You load this data, they do never delete the data from this, and they delete. So hence they are not going to delete. So what is going to happen? For example, I have a product called, you know, 1 and A is 10 rupees. This is a 2, B 20 rupees. Now when you load this data to the data warehouse, we have to understand, okay, so let me take this data and let me load it to data warehouse. Now the dimension table got loaded. Tomorrow you may add one more product here, say C product, and 30 rupees is the cost. Now when you go here, then if you don't perform incremental loading here, then how do you identify this data? It is very, very difficult. So to identify this, you have to have an incremental loading. So all the dimension tables, because new customer comes, product comes. So always dimension tables will have a logic of incremental loading. So this is a DIM table. So DIM product or something you can say. So DIM prod or whatever you can say. Okay. Now here you have to perform. Now think about, and the sales table here, and the sales table is having customer ID, product ID, and they purchased some 100 and they paid some 1,000 rupees. And customer 2 and the product they purchased 1, they customer is bought 20 and they paid some 2,700, like this. This is my sales data. Now what I am doing in the fact sales table, I am loading everything data here. So this is a fact sales table. Now let me take all this data and control, you have to load. After loading is you're deleting it here. Now you're deleting it. Now the new row comes again, product number 3, customer ID 4, and bots and this one. So now tell me, do I need to worry which is the new row here? So this is my sales table. I have the new row. So as it is, take this and append it. Try to understand. So incremental loading will come to identify, because old data and new data will get clubbed. So this data you have already loaded here, and you have to identify what is the new row. Because of that, you have to perform incremental loading here. Once you load the data and delete the data, so no data here, the new data only comes. Take this data as it is and dump it. So dump it, then you delete the data from there. When you delete the data, two things. One is that OLTP size will decrease. Then here simply you performing appending here. So the no need of, trying to understand what is the, the new rows or the old rows, because old rows will not be there at all. Or if they wanted to keep, they may keep it with the flag, the processed data. You can go to the flag. Processed means you can see. If the flag unprocessed means only take that rows and you have to dump here. Something like this. So end of the day, the sales table, once in a 6 months, once in a year, once they load the data, they will verify and they take copy of the sales table data, then they're going to trunk it. So because of this reason only, always you may have, little data here, but always you will not be having much of data, because you may have the remaining tables over there, because we're talking about only 2 tables here, right? And you may have thousands of tables. And always when you truncate this table, at least 1/3 database size will get reduced. Okay, like that you have to dump the data. So every time 300 GB, 300 GB, 300 GB, 200 GB, 100 GB, like that you are loading once in a 6 months, once in a year. So depends upon your criteria. And all 300 GBs or all 100 GBs, all, whatever, 200 MB, whatever be the size, 100 MB, 200 MB, whatever be the size, for 10, 20 years, when you load the data into the fact sales table, and this is going to have huge data. So trillions and millions of data will be there. and you're going to perform incremental loading, but this type, you know, these tables are will be part of dimensional tables, and here the data is not much, but here only the size is more. So always why the data warehouse size is more, only because of the fact sales table only. The fact tables will have more and more data, and here also you don't have much data here. Okay, because of the fact tables only, the data warehouse is also going to, you know, get. So whenever you design the fact tables, and they have to design appropriately, having proper, you know, files and file groups and different hard disks for this. And this table is very, very important table, and you have to load the data to this tables. And this table, they have to plan in the data warehouse, and nicely they have to design it. Okay. So that is what people would do it. Now today, what's going to happen? We have deleted all the data from here. So you can load a new row if you wanted to have. So for example, so let me insert a new row here. This is new customer is going to buy some item today. For example, now today customer, this is what is this? Product ID, right? So product ID say 4 and say customer ID 5. Let me give today's date. So you can also give today's date. Today is buying, and say is going to buy quantity sold 200 items. And what is the product master? So 5 Lux soaps is going to buy, and 200. So here I have to put 200. And the Lux soap cost is, you know, 22 rupees. So this is what I am putting it here. And this is, you know, the get date plus. So get date plus 3 days. So delivery date is always more. You can put like this, and let me insert a new value because I don't have any data here. So I have inserted a row. Now you can see the sales table here. Now 31st, and here September 30, and this is when the data would collect that. Insert some more data here. So I can say the customer is, you know, say 10 is going to buy a product called, say 12, and the items are, let me put some 300 items. Now I have to put 300 and the same 300, and you know the 12th item, let me check, the 12th item is mode number, it is 25 rupees. I am manually doing, otherwise you can automate this also. I did not automate it, but you can do it. So next, you know, product bought by customer number 9 and is going to buy product number 8. Product number 8 is what? 8 is Fair and Lovely. It is, you know, is going to buy, let me say, some 5. Okay, so 5 only is going to buy, and each one is going to cost you 55 bucks. Okay, so it is, you know, the 5 days later, the delivery is say 6 days later, like that. You can have some data, and let me take these two rows and let me insert. And when you go to the sales table, now you have 3 rows. Now again, always you have to go to staging. Always you have to get the data to the stage, right? So load data to the this. You have to go here and insert. Now only you will be able to get those 3 rows only. So after this, when you go to the stage table, and you are going to see only these 3 tables, because it's truncating loading here, and this is the fresh data. It's going to happen in this year. And now what we're going to do, we have to simply take this data and load it and go here and fact sales table. Now what I'm going to do, let me take this data and dump it here. Okay, so it is dumped. So now only 3 rows are going to go here. Now 3 rows only going, and depends upon the criteria, and the data would come here. So where is the data here? So now data did not get loaded, so there is a problem in this. What is the issue? So did I execute the correct package only? clue? So let me delete this data. Okay, so there is a problem here. You know the problem why they did not get loaded. So let me, you know, give you. So this kind of a things people would ask you. Let me load this data. It is getting the data here. And the three rows it is able to read. That is fine. And later it is, doing a comparison check. The data is not going further. And now tell me what could be the issue. Okay. The issue I will tell you is that the data did not go here. So these kind of an issues people would get it. Now I had stored the data like this. Okay. Now we have a sale date and I have declared as a dim time, but here I have stored the time also. When you use get date, the time is also stored. But in the previous, what I did was, so I'm storing the previous data completely 00 because the time is not there. Always the time is 00 like that. So when you store any data in the OLTP table, when you don't mention anything, it is completely 00. So the time is 00. So whenever you compare the sale date with the dim time date, so when you take, you know, dim time date and when you truncate and when you see the data, see now here there is no time at all. So when you compare this date with this, it is also comparing that time. Because of that time, it is, doing some kind of issues because the date is fine. The date we have 2016 date is there, today's date. But when you go here, when you go to 2016, the time will not be there. When the time is not matching, it is not able to pick up. So what is the better thing? So here, the putting, you know, like this is very, very bad. So they may write some kind of a commands here. The better you delete all this data, and this is my mistake, right? So this is a people are store the data like this only. So because I have made mistake in the data, these are the data issues. If you have data like this and suddenly customer sent this kind of a data and it is not going to pick up the data. But when customer promised, I am going to give you the data with that only date, then not with the time, but customer sent like this today, because of this going to give you some issues. Okay, remember, so you have to send me on this format data only. So these are the things you're going to learn. So now today is August, say 31st. And 3 days means September 3rd, something like this you may have. So you may have September 3rd, something like this. So you may take these dates and this is fine. And this is also fine. You may have some dates here. If when you do this, when you don't give the time, it is a fifth delivery. And these are the delivery on the 6th. So let us see whether it is going to insert or not. Okay, this is my doubt. And I have this. And now when you don't give that time, it is going with 000. Okay, now let me run the stage once again. So let me go to the stage sales and save and run. It's going to truncate all the data and the three rows again got loaded here. Let me go to the stage table and now let us see the timings and everything. It is 000. Now let me go here and start running the fact sales table and save and start. Now you're able to read and you're able to insert these three rows here and go. And let me go to this, data warehouse. Now I had fact sales table. Now you're able to get 30 rows. Now like that, the data was going to get appended here. So this is the new data. Have you seen? So this is the new data, 2016 data. Like that, you have to create and load it. Am I clear, guys? So this is how the fact tables are loaded. Now let me read the data from each and every table. If it is done, then you're done with this. Okay. Now, what are the tables we have? So let me go to the data warehouse and refresh. Now, I have dim customer, dim location, dim product, dim time, and fact sales. Okay, so these are the tables we have. Now read one by one. Let me read the data you have. Totally 49 rows you have, and you have totally 59 rows we have. You have data. You have a table here. Totally we have 92 rows, and the dim time table is having totally 2010 rows, and fact sales is also having some data, and here also we have 30 rows. Normally this will be having trillions of data, okay, but we have the data. And what kind of a schema, if you wanted to verify, simply go to the data warehouse and database diagrams, and new database diagrams you have to create, and take all the tables, whatever the tables you wanted to need, just take them. Okay, and include all the tables. You may have 1000 tables, and I don't need 1000 tables to see. Only I wanted to, you know, check only few tables and select only those tables. So because of the reason they have given this. Okay, now this is what is a star schema in the data warehouse. You have a dim customer table, you have a dim location table, you have a dim time table, you have a fact sales table, and below you have a dim product table. So when you go here, you can adjust this, or you can reduce the size. So let me reduce it to 75. So this is what is completely a star day, you know, the this one. So let us understand this. So this is how you can understand and take a picture, take a diagram. This is a data warehouse, so say tables, say star schema, something like this. You can create one diagram and keep it, or you can also need not keep it, so you can have this. So the columns you would understand, the primary keys you would understand, what are the everything you are able to understand. Now when you see here, one good thing you are able to understand, what is that? Now you are able to get, okay, two primary keys and two foreign keys. Why here? Because the sale date key data also you're getting from this primary key only, and the delivery date was also you are getting from this primary key only. So remember, so this table is giving two connections to this, and this table is giving only one connection. Why? This customer key, and this is a customer key, and this is a location key, and we have a location key. Where is the location key? When you come down, you have a location key, right? So this is also perfectly fine. Okay, and product key, but sale date key, this date key is a sale date key, and remember, and the same date key is a delivery date key also, because you're looking up full date and get the date key as a sale date key, and again look up full date and get the date key as a delivery date key. So one table only acting as a sale date, one table only acting as a full date, and one guy is acting as a, you know, dual role in the cinema, in a movies, right? Normally we see. So this dim time table is known as a role playing dimension table. Rhyming, okay. We had line types of dimension. Do you remember? Okay. We had learnt lots of types of dimension, right? Now I'm discussing a type of a dimension here, role playing dimension. What is a role playing dimension? Can you tell me? Is the important question. And which table can be used as a, you know, this one. So here we can say dim time table. Why? In the dim time table, we have only one thing, that is date key is there. The same date key is a primary key here, but this guy is acting in the fact table. In the fact table, I'm talking about fact sales table. The same date key is having a sale date key. The data you're getting for this from here only. So this is a foreign key. Okay, this is a foreign key here, but the data from where they're getting? They're getting from here only, and sale date key. So from this table only they're getting, and they have one more thing. What is that? Delivery date key. So delivery date key. Okay, so this is also foreign key. If you know one dim time only supplying the data to this, and a dim time only supplying data to this, now the dim time table is known as a role playing dimension table. When you have more than one when you have more than one this kind of a diagram, and this dim time table is known as a role playing dimension table, and I don't have anything here. For example, sometime the Amazon table is having some kind of a employee. So employee is also is going to buy some this one, right? So employee is employee. Employee can also become a customer. So employee ID also can, if they're having some kind of a decision, they may take from there also. So employee can become a customer. Employee can become an employee only. So that is employee table only, you know, working as a customer table, things like that. So not exactly like that, but you can understand. So here the better approach would be to understand role playing dimensions is this. Clear? Now, whenever you see more than one relationship, these are the tables. This table is known as a role playing dimension. So from one table only sending two types of data. Okay, so you're matching full date with, you know, this one and full date with this one, and you're doing and sending this data. So this is what we have to understand from this. Clear? And deliverables from the case study is, so everything is properly done. So you have to send all the scripts to the, you know, VSTF, and before, you know, proceeding further, so all the scripts will be run and people would do the testing. Now, what testing they are going to do? Your lead is going to perform a, you know, code review. Code review means they're going to go each and every, you know, code you have written. For example, you are the developer, I'm the lead developer. So before, you know, testing, what is going to happen is that peer review would happen. Peer review means what? Your friend, your same, you know, same position developer is going to come and review. Once the peer review is over, the same code will be submitted to the lead of your team. The lead is going to check each and every code, and we, including the document we have prepared for the deployment, and everything is going to see, and is going to give you some kind of a, you know, review comments. And you have to take the code review comments and you have to perform and modify. And later again, second, third review would happen, code review. Okay, code walkthrough, people would say code walkthrough or code review. People who should know technology very well, they have to know SSIS very well, they have to know SSRS very well, they have to know each and everything very well. So they only can do code review or code walkthrough. So once everything is done and you have to take all these scripts with this, you know, deployment gates and everything, and you're going to dump these scripts into VSTF or source code control, and you're going to write a mail to the, you know, testing team saying that my, you know, code review and everything is got over, the, you know, the code is ready for the testing purpose. That's it. The code is released to the testing department from tomorrow. They're going to test, and they're going to, again, based on their test cases, they're going to test your code, and they're going to use your deployment guide to install in the testing environment, and they'll have a staging server, and they'll have everything, how to install the packages in the staging and everything, where to keep the package, each and everything you have to mention. So all the data will go here and they're going to load it. Clear? So after that, they're also going to write, the testing is also done. They may take some 10-20 days. So it is not one day time. So the coding, the developers will take lots of time, because developer, if you take a 3 months time, and definitely the testing people will take another 10 days of time. And release probably is going to happen in one day. So much more time. So requirement phase. So what is that I have to do? Requirement may take, you know, 1 month of time, or if they may take some 10 days of time or 5 days of time requirement. Then you have to understand much more time will be taken by these guys only. Which guys they're going to take? So development guys. In the SDLC, software development lifecycle, you have to gather the requirement, analyze the requirement, then you have to code, you have to test, you have to release it, right? So requirement will take, say, 10% of the time or 20% of the time, and analysis and everything will take another 5%, then coding will take another 50 to 60% of the time, and 10% of the time or 20% of the time, you know, code review and code walkthrough, this thing. And release and modification another some 10-20%. Like that, the major portion will be given to you. Developer will have minimum 50 to 60% of the time. Remaining stages, requirement stage, analysis stage, and we talk, analysis means requirements, whether it is feasible or not. That analysis I'm talking about. Okay, if the client is saying I wanted to do this kind of analysis, they say this is what is not can happen, cannot happen, blah blah, that kind of analysis I'm talking about. So requirement, so analyze the requirements, then coding, then you do the testing, and you have to release. So development take 50 to 60% of the time, and remaining phase may take, you know, 5%, 10%, like that. So total it is 100%. So this is what is the thing you have to understand. So once you deploy the package and everything to the production, the it is going to happen slowly, and this is how the things would happen for each and every project. Clear? So do you have any questions, guys?